Good morning, students. Today we continue the fourth part of the chapter motion. Till now we have discussed what is position, what is scalar quantities, what is vector quantities, what is displacement, distance. Okay. Now we'll continue the speed. Okay. Now till now we have already discussed speed. Okay, so today we will see what is speed and some numericals regarding the speed. Okay, so speed is the distance covered. The distance covered per unit time. Okay, the distance covered per unit time is known as the speed, or we can say speed is the distance covered by an object in a given period of time. Clear? Now the speed is scalar quantity. Speed is scalar quantity. Unit is kilometer per hour or meter per second. Okay, kilometer per hour, meter per second. Clear? So the formula of speed will be speed is equal to distance covered upon time. Speed is equal to distance covered upon time. Clear? So distance covered can be kilometer or meter, or time can be kilometer or meter and hours or second. Okay, therefore the unit of distance is kilometer per hour or meter per second. Kilometer per hour or meter per second. Clear? So now we'll see one or two numericals related to the speed. For example, see the formula is speed is equal to distance upon time. Speed is equal to distance upon time. Okay, the question is if an object covers 40 kilometers in 20 minutes, okay, then calculate. Okay, 40 kilometers in 20 minutes, then calculate speed of an object. Now, first we will write what is given. 40 kilometers means distance is given. So, distance is equal to 40 kilometers. Time is given 20 minutes. So we have to calculate speed. Okay, we have to calculate speed. Now see, first we concentrate on the unit which is given. Unit is given in kilometer and this is in minute. Okay, but the unit of speed is either kilometer per hour or meter per second. Kilometer per hour, meter per second. Now, first unit, that is distance, is given in kilometer, but it is given in minute. Okay, so we'll convert the kilometer into meter. So 40 kilometer, if it is multiplied by 100, then it would be 4000 meters. Okay, and 20 minute. So 20 into 60, we have to convert minute into second. So 6 2s are 12 into 2, that is 1200 seconds. So you can see clearly we have converted kilometer into meter and minute into second. So we have to unit meter per second. Now we have to calculate the speed. See, the speed is equal to distance upon time. The distance we have covered is 4000.
40,000 meter. Okay, 40 into 1,000. 1, 2, 3, and 4 zeros are there. Therefore, 1, 2, 3, and 4 zeros are there. So 40,000 meters. Okay, upon the time is 1200 seconds. Okay, so 0 and 0 cancel out. So it would be 400 upon 12. So we'll cancel it. 4 threes are 12. So 100 upon 3, it would be 0 point, okay, 0.33 meter per second, okay, 0.33 meter per second, okay, or it would be 100 upon 3, 100 and 3, so 30, okay, or you can, simply cut 100 upon 3, it would be 33, okay, 0.33 meter per second. 100 upon 3 is 33.33 meter per second. If we divide 100 by 3, it would be 33.33 meter per second. Clear? Okay, I know. You know the division very well. Okay, so 100 upon 3, that would be 33.33. Clear or not? Okay, so whenever the question related to speed are given, first you have to focus what is the unit given, okay, and you have to convert that unit into the suitable unit. For example, when kilometer is given, so we have converted into meter, okay, kilometer are given, we have converted into meter, and minutes are converted into the seconds. Clear or not? In a given period of time, okay, velocity is the displacement of an object in a given period of time. So we define velocity is displacement of an object in a given period of time. Okay, in a given period of time, velocity is the displacement of an object in a given period of time, is known as velocity. So velocity, we can have the formula by the definition. Velocity is the displacement, okay, upon in a given period of time. Don't by heart the unit of any quantity. Okay, we should not by heart the unit of any quantity. By the formula we can have the unit. See, velocity is a displacement. Displacement is denoted by S, and in a given period of time, okay, is denoted by T. Now, in our earlier lecture, we have already discussed about the unit of displacement. The unit of displacement is meter, and the time is second. So we can have meter time in second. So this would be per second. Meter per second. See, S is in denominator. So when it will come in numerator, it will be the inverse form. Okay. So we can write meter per second like this, or we can write meter per second. Okay. Clear? In both ways, you can write it. There is meter per second. Clear? Okay, so velocity. Velocity is the displacement of an object in a given period of time. Velocity is displacement of an object in a given period of time. See, in speed also, we can divide the speed into four parts: uniform speed, non-uniform speed, instantaneous speed and average speed. Okay, we can divide the speed, okay, in four parts: uniform speed, non-uniform speed, instantaneous speed and average speed. Okay, like this we have, or we can divide the velocity into four parts. So velocity is again divided into four parts. Okay, uniform velocity, non-uniform velocity, average velocity and instantaneous velocity. Okay, velocity is divided into four parts like speed, uniform velocity, non-uniform velocity, average velocity and instantaneous velocity. Okay, now we discuss one by one what is uniform velocity, non-uniform velocity, average velocity or instantaneous velocity. Okay, so the first part of the velocity is uniform velocity. Okay, what is uniform velocity? Uniform velocity is if an object covers equal displacement in equal time. Okay, if an object covers equal displacement in a equal time, then it is known as uniform velocity. Okay, we don't have to buy that. Okay, the formula of velocity is displacement upon time, displacement upon time. So if an object covers equal displacement in equal time interval, then the velocity is known as uniform velocity. For example, an object covers 100 meter in 10 seconds, 200 meter in 20 seconds, 300 meter in 30 seconds. Okay, see, object covers 100 meter in 10 seconds, 200 meter in 20 seconds and 300 meter in 30 seconds. So we can say that object will have uniform velocity. Why it is uniform velocity? See, the difference between 100 and 200 is 100 only, and the difference between the 200 and 300 is 100. So the difference is same, and here also difference is 10 seconds and difference is 10 seconds. So according to the definition of uniform velocity, if the displacement of object is equal in equal interval of time, then it is known as uniform velocity. Similarly, non-uniform velocity is non-uniform velocity is what? If an object covers unequal distance in equal interval of time, then that velocity is known as non-uniform velocity. If an object covers unequal displacement, if an object covers unequal displacement in an equal period of time, then that velocity is known as non-uniform velocity. Examples would be, for example, if an object covers a displacement of 100 meter, if an object covers a displacement of 100 meter in 10 seconds, for example, it covers 120 meter in 15 seconds. For example, it covers 150 meter in 20 seconds or 18 seconds. Okay. Now you can see the difference between the displacement. The difference between the displacement is not equal, and the difference between the time interval is not equal. So when an object have unequal displacement in equal interval of time is known as non-uniform velocity. Okay. Or you can write here, for example, 100 meter in 10 seconds, another 120 meter in 10 seconds and 150 in 10 seconds. Then also it is non-uniform velocity. So we can define non-uniform velocity in two ways. First, if an object have equal displacement in unequal interval of time. Okay, or if an object have unequal displacement in unequal interval of time, it is known as non-uniform velocity. Okay, in short, we can understand non-uniform velocity by the interval between the displacement will be unequal and the interval between time will also be unequal. Okay, so the graph of non-uniform velocity also, okay, the graph of non-uniform velocity will also be in a curve form. It would not be in a straight line graph. Okay, if we plot the graph of velocity versus time, so we will not have a straight line graph, we will have a graph in a curve. Okay, it will not be a straight line graph. Clear? This is non-uniform velocity. Third is average velocity. Third is average velocity. Okay. Now what is average velocity? Average velocity means what? Average. Okay? Average. Average means the sum of all the things is divided by the number of things. Okay? For example, if we have the velocity. Now, for your information, the velocity are initial velocity and final velocity. The velocity are two. Okay? If velocity is again divided into two parts, initial velocity and final velocity. Okay? So, initial velocity is u, it is denoted by u, and final velocity, it is denoted by v. Initial velocity is denoted by u and final velocity is denoted by v. So, what would be the average velocity? Average velocity means the sum of all the velocities. Average velocity means the sum of all the velocities, that is initial velocity plus final velocity upon 2. Why it is divided by 2? Since we have two velocities, initial, final, therefore it is divided by 2. Okay, and this is known as the average velocity. This is known as the average velocity. Clear? Okay, we can have a small numerical on this. Okay, if a question is, if an object has, or if an object moves with velocity 20 meter per second and finally it accelerates with velocity of 30 meter per second in 10 seconds. Okay, in 10 seconds. Calculate average velocity. If a question is, if an object moves with a velocity of 20 meter per second and finally it accelerates with a velocity of 30 meter per second in 10 seconds, calculate the average velocity. Calculate average velocity. Now, how will calculate average velocity? See, initial velocity. Initial velocity is 20, final velocity is 30, and time is given 10 seconds. Okay? So, initial, what is initial velocity? Initial velocity is average velocity is equal to initial velocity plus final velocity upon 2. What is initial velocity? 20. What is final velocity? 30 upon 2. So, 50 upon 2, the answer will be 25 meter per second. Okay? Initial velocity plus final velocity divided by 2 is known as the average velocity. Okay? And the fourth type of velocity is Fourth type of velocity is instantaneous velocity. Instantaneous velocity. It is very easy. Instant means what is instant at particular time. Okay, at a particular time. Instant. Okay. See, instantaneous velocity means what? Instantaneous velocity means, for example, if any object moves with a velocity of 40 meter per second and for 30 seconds. Okay, if any object moves with a velocity of 40 meter per second for 30 seconds, then what would be the velocity at any particular time? For example, if I have to find out what would be the velocity of object at 15 second. Okay, at 15 second. Object moves with the velocity of 40 meter per second for 30 seconds, from 1 to 30 seconds. But if I want to know what would be the velocity at 15th second and 16th second or 17th second, so at a particular time instant, at any particular time instant, we want to know the velocity, then that velocity would be known as instantaneous velocity. For example, at 15th second, okay, if I want to know what would be the velocity at 15th second, so at 15th second, the velocity of object would be instantaneous velocity. Or you can say at 20th second, at 21st second, what would be the velocity? So if we'll find out that velocity at any particular time instant, that is known as instantaneous velocity. Clear? Okay. So the next concept is acceleration. Next concept is acceleration. Okay, acceleration. Acceleration means the change in velocity. Okay, change in velocity with respect to time is known as the acceleration. What is acceleration? Acceleration means change in velocity with respect to time. Okay? See, this is final velocity, this is initial velocity. So final minus initial, that means what? The difference in the velocity. The difference in the velocity with respect to time. The difference in the velocity with respect to time is known as acceleration. It's known as acceleration. The unit for acceleration is c. A is v minus u upon t. See, velocity. Velocity is meter per second and time is in second. So this would be meter. Second and second will be multiplied to each other. So meter upon second square. So the unit will be meter per second square. Okay? The unit for acceleration is meter per second square. And acceleration is which quantity? Okay? Your homework is find out acceleration is scalar quantity or vector quantity. Okay, that was all for today's lecture. I hope you have understood what we have learned today. Thank you.